Hey y'all, Jay on Real Guys Reviews. Well, I'm out at the range today to talk to you about and shoot an exciting lineup of little snub-nosed revolvers. That's the Smith and Wesson Airweights. In 1950, at the Association of Chief of Police Convention, Smith and Wesson introduced one of the most popular line of revolvers they've ever had. And that's the, at that time, called the Chief Special because of where it was introduced, later to be designated the Model 36. This was the first steel snub-nose revolver that Smith had come out with to shoot the 38 special round that they actually invented or developed back in 1902. Following the Chief Special in 1950, later becoming the Model 36, three lines of snubbies were developed by Smith. The Chief Special line, also because it has an external hammer. Then we have the Bodyguard line, designated so because it has a shrouded hammer, still has an external hammer. Smith calls it their concealed hammer. You can still get to it, so it's double action, single action, just like the little Chief Special is. And then the third line is a Centennial, which is a completely internal hammer. Other than the hammer designation, this one being Chief Special external hammer, the Bodyguard being shrouded, the Centennial being completely internal, these guns are identical. The trigger pull's identical, their aluminum alloy, stainless steel cylinder, stainless steel barrel. Their barrels are 1¾ inches on these little snubbies. The triggers are right at 12 pounds out of the box. They have 5 in the stainless steel cylinder. Not much to speak of with the integral sight system on them, but it's enough, like most of these little snubbies have. So now let's go ahead and look at each one separately as we shoot it and see which one you might want to pick out if you go looking for a little Smith snubby. Okay, the Model 637. That's all there is to lock and loaded a little revolver. No safeties, no decockers, no racking of anything. Just simply pop in the cylinder, pull the trigger. Very simple, very reliable. This is the Chief Special Model 637. Double action, 12 pounds. Now, why would we want maybe a hammer? Let's just see what this single action is. This measures 4 pounds by me, so the single action, you barely touch the trigger, single action, and it goes off. That means that we have a lot easier time with trigger control, single action, with a little gun. The Model 637, right down from the Chief Special with the external hammer, 4 pound single action, 12 pound double action. Much easier single action. Defensively, you need to learn to shoot all three of these double action. Also, I'm going to put the name of an article by Masada Yud. If you want to go to it and read more information about why legally it's best to shoot double action with these little revolvers in a defensive situation. And we won't talk much more about that, but if you're interested, take a look at that. The Model 638, the little Bodyguard version of the Model 36 or Chief Special. Now in the mid-50s, or actually early 50s, the LE said, you know, we're snagging on the hammer, so can you take off the hammer spur but still do something so that we can shoot it single if we want to? So to keep it a single action, double action, they simply took the hammer spur off, shrouded it so that it's smooth and doesn't snag, but yet you can still get to the hammer to shoot it single action. And once again, single action is right at 4 pounds, hairpin, double action is 12. So if you're in a situation where you want to use it single action, it's still easy to do. Trigger control obviously is much easier with a 3 to 4 pound trigger than it is a 12. Or you can stay with a 12 pound double action. It's smooth, but it's every bit of 12 pounds. Let's see how this little Bodyguard, as it was called in the early 50s, but now the 638. Six designated because of the stainless steel component in the gun. All right, 5 in the cylinder, little 638. Double action, single action. Let's just take a little feel of this 12 pound double action trigger. Now, we want a single action. See what we do with it. Hairpin trigger, There is virtually no trigger control to deal with when you're single action with this. See, way out there. Didn't do so good there, did I? Little Smith and Wesson 638. If you still want the double action, single action, but you don't want the hammer spur hanging on you and coming out of your pockets, maybe this is a deal for you. Now let's take a look at one of the most popular guns Smith & Wesson has ever made, the Model 642 Centennial Series. The Centennial airweight descendant of Model 36. Again, this model airweight, just like the other two, aluminum alloy frame, stainless steel cylinder and barrel, everything else is identical to the 637, 638 that we looked at, with a couple of exceptions. One is this one has the crimson trace sight with it. The other is, as we noted, its internal hammer. This little Centennial airweight, 2006, most popular gun sold by Smith & Wesson. Outsold every gun they had. Still one of the most popular revolvers made. The Centennial airweight, double action only, as opposed to the double action, single action of the other two. Shoots identical to the other two with that absolutely smooth 12-pound trigger. It is 12 pounds, but it's very smooth. The advantages of these little guns, they're light, they're carryable, they're simple. You just close a cylinder, pull the trigger. There's no decockers, decocker safeties. You don't have to rack the slide. Just simply close the cylinder and pull the trigger. Now, from a shootability aspect of them, you need to practice, or at least I certainly did and do. These little guns have heavy triggers. There's a reason for that. No safeties, so the trigger's heavy to be safe when you're carrying it in your pocket or purse. Short barrel, that makes for these little guns a little bit harder to accurately shoot. Trigger control is something that most of us have to work at pretty good with them. But from the standpoint of reliability, the standpoint of simplicity, you really can't beat these little guns. So if it's the Model 637, or the Bodyguard descendant, 638, or maybe the most popular concealed carry gun sold in the world, the 642, it's going to be hard to beat these guns from a concealed carry standpoint. The descendants of the Smith & Wesson Model 36, 637, 638, and the 642. Thanks for viewing our videos here at Real Guys Reviews. We appreciate it. Hope to see you around.